الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام رسول الكريم أما بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم My dear brothers and sisters in Islam and in humanity السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته May peace, mercy and blessing of Allah be upon you Today my topic is The Quran and Modern Science Compatible or Incompatible Ever since the dawn of human life on this planet, man has always sought to understand nature, his own place in the scheme of creation and the purpose of life itself. In this quest for truth, spanning many centuries and diverse civilizations, organized religion has shaped human life and determined to a large extent the course of history. While some religions have been based on books claimed by their adherents to be divinely inspired. Others have relied solely on human experience. Al-Quran, the main source of the Islamic faith, is a book believed by Muslims to be of completely divine origin. Muslims also believe that it contains guidance for all mankind. Since the message of the Quran is believed to be for all times, it should be relevant to every age. Does the Quran pass this test? I intend to give an objective analysis of the Muslims' belief regarding the divine origin of the Quran in the light of established scientific discoveries in oceanology. Barrier between sweet and salt waters. Consider the following Quranic verses. He has let free the two bodies of flowing water meeting together. Between them is a barrier, which they do not transgress. Al-Quran 55 verse 19 to 20. In the Arabic text, the word barzakh means a barrier or a partition. This barrier is not a physical partition. The Arabic word maraja literally means they both meet and mix with each other. Early commentators of the Quran were unable to explain the two opposite meanings for the two bodies of water, i.e. they meet and mix, and at the same time there is a barrier between them. Modern science has discovered that in the places where two different seas meet, there is a barrier between them. This barrier divides the two seas so that each sea has its own temperature, salinity, and density. Oceanologists are now in a better position to explain this verse. There is a slanted, unseen water barrier between the two seas through which water from one sea passes to the other. But when the water from one sea enters the other sea, it loses its distinctive characteristics and becomes homogenized with the other water. In a way, this barrier serves as a transitional homogenized area for the two waters. This scientific phenomenon mentioned in the Quran was also confirmed by Dr. William Hay, who is a well-known marine scientist and professor of geological science at the University of Colorado, USA. The Quran mentions this phenomenon also in the following verse, and made a separating bar between the two bodies of flowing water, Al-Quran 27 verse 61. This phenomenon occurs in several places, including the divider between the Mediterranean and the Atlantic Ocean at Gibraltar. But when Quran speaks about the divider between fresh and salt water, it mentions the existence of a forbidding partition with the barrier. It is He who has let free the two bodies of flowing water, one plantable and sweet, and the other salty and bitter. Yet has he made a barrier between them, and a partition that is forbidden to be passed. Al-Quran 25 verse 53. Modern science has discovered that in estuaries where fresh sweet and salt water meet, the situation is somewhat different from that found in places where two seas meet. It has been discovered that what distinguishes fresh water from salt water in estuaries is a ficlonine zone, which with a marked density discontinuity separating the two layers. This partition zone of separation has a salinity different from both the fresh water and the salt water. This phenomenon occurs in several places, including Egypt, where the river Nile follows into Mediterranean Sea. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.